typically aware of the census, but the actual response rate is much lower. So that would be another hurdle.
Would you concur or disagree that the census is rooted in Article 1 of the Constitution, which enumerates the powers of the legislative branch?
Oh, I will pass on that one.
I guess the question is, who do you believe the census director reports to?
Well, legally, to the Commerce Secretary. That, I believe, is in statute.
And is it your experience from past decennials that the director often briefed the president but never, quote-unquote, reported to him?
Well, I mean, for what we've seen in news accounts and also from some experience during the Bush administration, there was some contact between the census director and the White House, OMB, and that's not necessarily a bad thing. I mean, it was reported here today, the census.
But communication is a little different than actually reporting
right,
to.
Right, and there are two different things. It's one thing for the White House to be aware of and make sure that the census stays on track, but that is not a reporting relationship. But in terms of holding the Bureau accountable, it's a very powerful tool to have White House involvement. The thing is that the White House, it has to be that right balance between focusing on management and operational issues versus the science of the census. You don't want the White House or any political influence on the science of taking the census.
Very good. Thank you, Mr. Chair.
Thank you, Mr. Chambers. Just one question for Dr. Himes. You know, the Bureau is working with MITRE on mitigation plans. What are your greatest concerns about timetables and the plans?
So I think, again, our greatest concern would be those that GAO has put together, that the time to test and verify where the systems are working, particularly from a system view. So we think that there are tools in place that give Census better insights into the status of their systems than they've had in the past, and the people that are working on them have substantial experience, but it's still a fairly large burden considering the amount of time remaining to track that whole activity end to end.
Thank you so much for that response, Dr. Hamm. I'll yield to Mr. Westmoreland.
Well, thank you, Mr. Chairman. I appreciate that. I didn't have any other questions, but Mr. Goldenkopf passed on the Article 1 of the Constitution question. I felt like we might want to discuss that a little bit further, that the GAO understands that we feel like the census, the origin of the census is rooted.
Oh, that, no question. Article 1, Section 2. Maybe I misunderstood
In Article 1 of the Constitution, then, which enumerates the power of the legislative branch. And so,
yes.
You know, I just wanted to make sure that you understood that and you were just passing on the question maybe for.
No, I guess I misunderstood the question. I apologize,
okay.
But definitely
it's
Article 1, Section 2, and that spells out the basic requirements of the census.
And, you know, I think, and Mr. Chairman, I would like to just make just a comment, if I could, that we all understand how important this census is for redistricting, for the allocation of federal money. And I'm very pleased with the testimony that we've heard today, because I think that everybody on that panel wants to have an accurate count, an enumeration of everybody in this country, people who were here at the time of the census. And so I think that's the reason that, you know, there's been so much about, you know, whether the White House wants to have it reported to, or the Commerce Secretary, there is or is not a director. I feel very confident from just the information I've heard from the Census Bureau and the acting director there, and from the GAO and the things that they've looked at, that this process is going forward about as well as it could, and that there's been a lot of hard work put into it. And so I think that the reason there's so much going on right now is everybody wants to make sure that every person is counted. And so I appreciate all of you coming. I want to thank the chairman for having this hearing, because I think he recognizes the importance to each and every one of us and the fact that we get a very accurate count. And so with that, Mr. Chairman, I'd yield back to balance my time.
Thank you, Mr. Westmoreland. And, you know, in conclusion, let me thank the witnesses for their testimony today.
If I could ask just one.
Oh, you have another question?
Yeah, I'm sorry.
Okay, I'll yield to Mr. McHenry.
I'm sorry, Mr. Chairman. I just wanted to get this on the record. Mr. Metzberg, from the Census Bureau's perspective, and I'm sure these are questions you'd like to answer. Any and all the information obtained from the census forms cannot be used for any other purpose, including tax or law enforcement purposes. Is that correct?
That's correct.
Okay. Many of us have received feedback from our constituents regarding privacy concerns, obviously very, very, very much in mind today, especially. But information given by people to the Census Bureau is confidential by law. Is that correct?
By law, by Title 13.
All right. And the main challenges, well, getting people to respond is one of the main challenges, yeah, as you mentioned. So is there, because people maybe have a mistrust of government, what efforts are you taking to ensure that that people know that any information given to them, is kept only within the Census Bureau and not shared with any other government agency, department, or any other individual?
Well, that information will be on the report form that everybody receives, but probably more importantly, it's going to be a key focus of our advertising message and our partnership program. So it's one thing for the Census Bureau to tell people it's confidential. In the hard-to-reach segments of the population, our partnership program is aimed to get a trusted voice in that community to tell people that live in that community, and our partnership specialists will be hired from the community that they're working in, that you can trust the Census Bureau that they'll hold your data confidential.
Certainly. And finally, if you and your staff could prepare a follow-up for this. This is too long of a question. Our time is short. I'd like to know the Census Bureau's full plan to minimize the undercount and overcount. And I know you already have plans in place, but if we could receive that, I think that would be important for committee members to hear the full breadth and depth of your plan, and so we can also see ways that we can engage other stakeholders.
Certainly.
And thank you all. And thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Very good. I certainly appreciate it. Very good. Thank you. And the first major operation of the 2010 census, address canvassing begins on March 30th. There will not be any other opportunities to build a complete and accurate address list. Time is of the essence. It is critical that the Bureau work with GAO, MITRE, and use every resource available to get this right. Six major systems still need to be tested. The life cycle cost estimate needs to be validated, and testing must be prioritized. Let me thank all of the witnesses for coming today, and thank the members of this committee for their singular focus and their commitment to seeing that the 2010 census be successful. And on that note, this hearing is adjourned. Thank you.